Hey yo, what's going on everybody? It's Tylarious, aka Ty Killington. Yeah, man. Alright, I'm back at it with another review from the Cayo Perico DLC. Tons of content today, guys. A lot of guides, tutorials, and reviews will be coming from my channel. Make sure you are subscribed. Make sure you have notifications turned all the way on. Definitely, you know it's going to be a banger. Go ahead and smash that like button. You know what's going to be a banger, all right? Anyway, so yeah, in this video, I'm going over a review, complete full review on the new assault rifle in the game. It is called the military rifle. We're going to go over the price, the performance, and whether or not it's worth even buying or if it's going to be viable to be used in GTA 5 online. The military rifle comes in at a staggering $345,825. Now, I do have a 13% discount available because of being commended. All right. So if you got some buddies, make sure they commend you in the game for, you know, good behavior, for being friendly or helpful, and you will get discounts overall in the game. And that does add up when you're spending, you know, several hundred thousand dollars on a weapon. Okay. As you see here, we got the damage, the fire rate, the accuracy, the range, all that good stuff. And we will be comparing this with the Mark II Special Carbine, which is kind of like the new, this overall meta for the assault rifles, okay? As you see here, we have the default clip, which is 30 rounds. The Extendo for $54,000 is going to give you only 45 rounds, okay? You have the scope at $30,875. Remember, I have discounts, so it's a little bit different with my pricing. The flashlight's $13,000. The suppressor is almost $50,000, okay? Now, I will be testing all these guns fully maxed out with accuracy. The Mark II does have a few extra, perks to it because it is the Mark II variant. But again, I want to test it against kind of, you know, what's considered overall the meta. You know, it's just the overall, the workhorse of the assault rifle class, all right? Now, the suppressor does affect the stats a little bit. However, from my testing, I find out that it does improve recoil. So I want to keep it as same or as close to the same as I can between these two weapons. So I have a suppressor on both of them. All right, to kind of give you guys a good idea. We will be testing the lethality from different ranges, the lock-on range compatibility, the recoil, and the spread and rate of fire. Everything, all right? Big shout out to the crew for helping me out. Luxray, big shout out to you, man. Thank you so much. And everybody else that was out there giving me a hand as well. You see right here, we have a little bit of difference in stats, right? With the Mark II, a little bit less damage, better fire rate, better accuracy. The range is actually about the same, and we'll test that here in just a minute. Now, for my testing, I used the light markers at the airport. They're roughly 10 feet apart from end to end. And I'm testing the average distance that two players usually engage in a PvP battle. It's roughly 70 feet, all right, or roughly 7 of these markers. So we're going to test the lethality real quick. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 rounds to kill a another player with full health, all right? Now, against the Special Carbine Mark II, count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, the military rifle can kill two shots quicker, all right? Now, we have full armor. And basically, what the full armor does is it adds 2 rounds for each gun. So, instead of 9, it's 11. Now, this is the super heavy vest, the best one. As you saw right there, you can count along. It's 11 rounds. With the Mark II, we start at 60. You can go ahead and count on your own. However, the Special Carbine Mark II will destroy a player in 13 rounds with a full armor, super heavy armor vest on. Okay, it ends at 47. That's 13 rounds. So it adds 2 for each gun. Again, it seems that the military rifle has the advantage. Now we're testing the auto lock distance. The range is about the same. It's at 190, between 190 and 200 feet, okay? Roughly 19 to 20 markers. All right, now we're gonna test the lethality at the actual range of their max lock-on, okay? And what you notice here is something kind of strange, very interesting. Now, we're starting out with the military rifle. It has starts out with 45 rounds. It actually takes 11 rounds before we can kill the player at max lock-on range, okay? With the Mark II Special Carbine, the same. So it takes at max lock-on range, right at 195, 200 feet, it takes 11 rounds to kill the target. Now what we're doing is we're testing, basically we're just going, you know, we're starting at the same exact time and we're testing the lethality of the guns versus each other, right? If you were just to lock on and start shooting instantly. What I find out with the testing is that up close at 70 feet away, the guns are equal. The paper, rock, scissor counterbalance is actually pretty good. It's very, very equal. However, when you get to the max range, that's where the military rifle really loses a lot of its power, and it's no match for the Mark II Special Carbine. So if you're up close, they're even, which you would think that that shouldn't be the case. However, it's because of this right here. It's because of the rate of fire being much slower in the Special Carbine and the recoil. The recoil is just a little too much. We're testing that right now. All right, I'm at that same 70-foot range right here. And I'm not even touching the joystick. I'm just pulling the trigger, letting it go. And what you'll notice is that this is the most important thing. Notice the first to second shot. It's much tighter. And the overall spread, vertical and horizontal, is tighter with the Mark II. Plus, you hold more rounds and you can get through those rounds at a quicker rate than you can with the military rifle. All right. Now we are at a further range testing the recoil, and this just further, you know, kind of exposes the disadvantage of that slower rate of fire and that bigger gap with the recoil, you know, gives us with that military rifle versus the Mark II Special Carbine right here. We're going through the rounds with this guy. And listen, if you're in a PvP situation, recoil matters, accuracy matters, the ammo, how much you can hold matters as well. And again, notice the first to second shot. At range, it's even more evident. Again, notice that difference between the first and second shot. That spread and that jump because of the recoil is a big deal. Real quick, just wanted to test the bulletproof helmets, and it's the same. Three shots from each assault rifle, so really no difference in that. There you have it, guys. Really good testing, really interesting things that we found out with it. And it's just kind of a bummer. I really was hoping that this rifle would kind of be like the new meta. There may be, you know, it's still a viable weapon. You can still use this. It's still a good gun. I just think that, you know, the Special Carbine Mark II is still going to be that workhorse that we've all been relying on. That one, the Combat MG, you know, those two rifles are just, you know, it's hard to beat those. And you see that right here with this testing. At the very least, they're as good, and there's really no dominant. So I guess for balance, it's a good thing. You know, but we saw there at range, it's hard to beat that Special Carbine Mark II variant. It really is. So good testing all the way around. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Thank you so much for coming out of the video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel for the illest and realest content in the game. Smash that like button. We'll see you guys in the next one, right? Peace out. Yeah.